guys. Today we're going to take a look at Bulls versus Lakers in the NBA playoffs, the sequel to Lakers Celtics. One game, so let's take a look. Tournament, one player. Oh, you can do co-op tournament mode in this one. You still can't change the difficulty though. Arcade, preseason, 5. So I believe, okay. So more teams in this one. All, because the first one there was only, because there the playoff NBA playoffs had 16 teams, but they only showed 8 on the original. This one they show all 16. So we're gonna go with the Pistons, of course, and then press for the Genesis. We're gonna go a team over here. We're gonna go with Seattle. I think you can read this. I wish the music could continue. Okay, Lambeer, Kemp, Rodman, McKee, Edwards, Benjamin, Thomas, Payton, Dumars, Threat? That's his name? Really? That's cool. Same guys. Sally, there's some good bench people, but I'm not really. This time you have a star, because I didn't know this in the first game, but the player you control was based on, like, the color shoes that they had. I noticed that the speed's faster. Now, I thought the first one, I thought I left it on the default arcade and everything, but because they said in the arcade mode there really shouldn't, I read the manual for today and it said that in the arcade mode there really shouldn't be any fouls or anything, but well, they kind of let you pass it in now. There we go. Oh, wow. You can't really move around the defenders, but it's virtually the same team as the one before this one, which is cool, because really, that didn't count? C is steel. A is jump and B is switch. Like on each team, has a player that can do a special move if under the right circumstances. I thought they had something like that in the original, but I can't say for sure. Yeah, the star icon's a much better system. I don't know what the Pistons one is. I just looked it up on Wikipedia, and they don't have all the details there. They might have it in the manual, though. I'll have to look that up. I feel like it's a little bit faster, but also still feels a bit slow. Tied it up. Oh! Yeah, we're keeping the same guys then. Oh, yeah. Charging. I may have to go back on the first video and see if I forgot to change the settings for the game. Because, I don't know, maybe I left it on the default on a different one. Because if that was the case, that could have... There we go. Like I said before, I still kind of like it that it's not every single NBA team, because in all honesty, while it's unfortunate for fans of other teams not to be able to play as their team, most of the teams in the bottom 16 are kind of shitty in these games, and I kind of like just limiting it to like the best, you know? limiting it to the best. Because really, you just, because most people, if they play this game, they're gonna usually pick the better team to play, especially back then, because games were had a high difficulty, a little bit more of a strict difficulty rating back then. Three. And there are overalls in this game. Like, the statistics are the overalls in this game. Like, if the player has a lot of rebounds, then they'll have a high rebound attribute, and so on. That's kind of what they went for with this. There we go. Sweet. But yeah, the special moves are only on specific one player of each team, a starter, I believe. And you have to, like, do, like, specific things, like you have to be going in a certain direction and press certain buttons and everything. And you know what, with this having the co-op, it might make going through the tournament mode with the bud much easier. Because the difficulty has to be on the hardest. Oh, right over. Out of bounds. I will say they do stick with you though. It does help create like some more strategic passing, so it's not a complete like back and forth of like crazy like sloppiness, but oh wow, Bailen Beer with the free. There we go. Wow, they got a last minute shot. Still like my guys. And they actually have the jersey numbers. You can see the jersey numbers. This is actually a very detailed game. And the thing is that I'd rather have the highest quality with little teams than just have a bunch of them have the quality just be shit. You know? And one. That's gonna be terrible. Shit. Damn it. Oh, really? There we go. Oh, so mine cool. The key is switching at the best possible second to go to put a hand in their face. Shit. really fucking Rodman. Shit. Alright. Take your time. No need to rush it. Did I win? Yes, I won it. Rodman, most rebounds Lambeer, most 3-pointers Lambeer, percentage. Oh wait, no, the C is center, okay. Okay, so we're gonna end it here. That was Bulls Lakers in the NBA playoffs for the Sega Genesis. Now, I don't know what this game. This felt so much easier, and nothing has really changed that much compared to the previous one, really. Except maybe I just forgot to change the other settings. I'll have to check, but I think I did. Regular season showtime, yeah. Ah. There's a little password system. But yeah. It's a pretty good game, I think. I think it is a bit better than the first one just because a lot of small things, like more teams being able to go with the player. They kept the control scheme about the same. I think this game's a little bit faster, but I don't think by much. But I don't mind it, because it makes you kind of pass it and shoot and not necessarily going for NBA Jam style stuff. And you know what? I enjoyed this game. I enjoyed the first one too, but I enjoyed this one too as well. So it's a good game. If you see it in the stores, don't be afraid to pick it up. And plus, it still has the Piston Bad Boys on this one. I'm curious what Pistons team's going to be on the next one. I don't know if Pistons are on the next one. We'll have to see. But, yeah, guys, thanks for watching. Please subscribe and like the videos, and have a good day.